So I took my heelys in, but they wouldn't let me have them. And then, because I just thought it'd be really cool to like have a very serious conversation and then heely away.
And how was that for you?
It's Joanna out.
It sent a shiver up my spine. Hi, I'm Harriet Rose and welcome back to Under the Duvet. As you know, we are always live Wednesdays at 5 p.m. with the podcast. Plus you can watch us, isn't that lovely, every Thursday at 12 o'clock. And I am personally extremely excited because of course we've got a lot to chat about today. We've had the Love Island All-Stars final and I've got two incredibly special guests who are fresh off the plane. It's Chris and Joanna.
I don't know what my hammer's doing there. It feels weird me not being over there.
I don't know
what to do here.
How does it feel not presenting the show?
I don't know, just weird. I'm not sure I'm all right with it.
To be fair, I don't know how all right we were when we suddenly came to do the show and you were on a plane to South Africa.
Yeah, sorry
welcome
about
to
that,
the
guys.
Other side, Chris.
No, yeah, it's weird.
Yeah, it's weird. Welcome to the other side. There's been a lot that has gone down. For you, Chris, your journey's been whoop-de-whoop roller coaster, and between the two of you, there's a lot to say.
Mm.
And we're going to get into that in a bit because we obviously have to kick off and talk about the Love Island All-Stars final.
Yes.
Firstly, before we get into it, though, who was on your flight home? Because you've literally just got off a flight, right?
Yeah, I was with the boys. So me, Casey, Mitch, Ty, the others, Joe. I can't remember everyone. There's a lot of people on the flight.
Okay. And yeah. Joe, when did you fly back?
So the girls flew back in the morning and the boys were in the evening. So we were...
They don't let us, like, cross paths in the slightest.
I was going to say, are they scared you're going to start making out on the flight?
No, literally, they're terrified of it.
We were kept apart, weren't we?
Separate hotels. We had a lovely hotel. They were in a less lovely hotel with seagulls pooing in the in their pool.
Situation.
We had turtles. We had tortoises, like, knocking around.
Oh.
No, so the situation was us girls landed. The boys hadn't landed yet in South Africa. And we were like, Chris sent me the hotel they're staying in. And I was like, why are we not staying there? Like, we were staying in like a one that wasn't as great. And then so we called up the producers and we're like, right, the boys haven't landed yet. Like, let's switch us over. Like, come on. And they were going, no contact. And we're going, please.
As if the betrayal in the villa wasn't enough.
No, the tea is hot.
But then on the way back, they got direct flights. We had connecting. So we've been traveling for 24 hours. I've not slept yet. And
can't wait for what you're
she's
say
been
on
in
this
her bed, cozy with the dog.
Yeah, too right. You've been in such a nice hotel.
And I do agree with that.
Yeah, seagulls literally bathing.
We
in
had
the
a
pool.
6 hour layover in Johannesburg.
Four.
It was six. You weren't there.
He's lying. I do feel like a 6 hour layover is worth it to have the way better hotel.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, no, it does level out. I'll give you that.
Mitch and Hannah, when they flew back, got absolutely lit and were like spilling red wine all over everyone. Did you guys have similar experiences?
No, that's entirely Hannah's doing that.
Yeah.
She loves it.
I want to go on a flight with
Hannah. I've got the best voice note of her ever, which is basically like 20 seconds of her whinging about vaping, not being able to go to the offie and not being able to have a drink.
In
her accent.
Yeah.
Everything in her accent is better.
Yeah.
She's amazing.
I think a whinge in that accent I'd even deal with. Yeah.
All she does is moan, but it's hilarious.
Yeah.
It's like the best moaning I've ever heard.
And rapping.
Not like that.
She loves to rap.
Yeah.
Chris.
Everything she does is just acceptable. What did you say?
Nothing.
Yeah, I hope you didn't hear it because it might be another ick for you.
Oh, no. Walking in.
Well, no, to be fair, we should talk about this while we're here.
Not yet.
What? You're gunning for me today.
Yeah, you know
I feel
that.
It.
We started a war yesterday.
Lack of sleep, and he's coming for me.
Listen, one thing about Chris, don't ever let him be tired or hungry because it is not fun.
Oh, to be
that's
fair,
facts.
I'm a bit like
you're
that.
Worse. Yeah, yeah.
He is a big grumpy bear when he is tired and
I'm
hungry.
An angry elf, yeah.
Okay, so the drama of the final. So Molly and Tom were our winners.
Yeah.
Jess and Callum in second place. Is that what we expected? Only 2% of the vote was in it to see who won. So Tom and Molly got 2% more of the vote. Did you know that?
Really?
Yeah, no, I knew that. That is insane.
It is insane, isn't it? It's probably the closest final we've seen in a long time.
Especially when you think about actually, there's only really two people in that. Do you know what I mean?
I feel like
it was Molly and then it was Callum. It was Molly versus Callum.
Yeah.
Really, if we're being honest. No offence to anybody else involved, but that's the fact of the matter.
Was it 2% between Molly and Callum's couples?
Yeah.
To win?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you meant 2% between, like, they got two... I don't know what I was thinking. I'm not good with maths.
Okay, so going forward, we know Joanna's not good with numbers, so I won't bring any percentages back into the conversation from now. How orky porkies to be sat next to your ex of 3 years with your new partner and you're both in the Love Island final?
I know, yeah, ridiculous. I don't know how they dealt with that, but they seemed fine with it. But actually, while in there, they weren't like weird around each other in the slightest. Maybe really? A bit at first.
Yeah.
But they got, they...
It was so fun.
You didn't see as much. It was only like 2 days or so.
He used this joke in the back, right? And he's using it again. He's obviously got a script, okay, that he goes by. I've always jokes jotted down.
Could I intervene here and just say, could I just say, right, you are the type of person, right, that digs me out for saying things and then says them a week later and then looks at me like as if I'm not going to remember what I said. But anyway, sorry, we're diving.
Shall I go? Because I feel like I'm the third wheel in this scenario yet again.
Well, give us a blanket. Just keep your hands over the top, yeah? I don't...
Yeah. Okay. I'm not going to lie, guys. I want to talk about this now, but we've got too much to talk about. The energy.
We've been flirting for 24 hours.
Palpable. Palpable. And also, can I tell you, I can see you, Joanna, from here. The amount you are flipping down and looking at his lips when he talks, that is a very good sign. If a girl looks at my lips, I know she wants to kiss them.
This is interesting.
I think you're looking at your nose piercing.
Fuck off. All I needed was
To be fair, I look at that a lot and I'm like...
Oh, yeah, because he always does this. I'm like, you're picking your nose.
I'm moving it.
He spins it around a lot. So, biggest talking point has been Molly and Callum, right? And are they ever going to get back together? Mm. I do feel like everyone was just desperate for it. Is it because in life, the girly whirlies and some of the boy-y boys really love the idea of that? You know when you break up with someone and you're like... maybe in 10 years' time, we're going to get back together and we're going to get married. I feel like everyone wants to believe in that truth, but it very rarely, from my experience, actually works out.
Mm.
Do you think that's what was driving everyone to want them to get back together in the public?
It's like a love story, isn't
yeah.
it? Why the stare like that?
It's
like a love story, I think. So like a love film. So I've got
what's that one with Ryan Gosling in?
Oh, no, that's not a good example of love.
No.
That's not a good example. You mean, what's it called? The Notebook.
The Notebook.
No, that's sad, isn't it?
Yeah, but it is that idea. People love the idea.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
And if
but
I
it's
was...
not a good example of a relationship.
No. It's the only one I could think of on the
yeah,
spot.
No. As in, you're right, but it's still a bit worrying that that's what people look at and they're like, yes, I want this relationship where we're screaming at each other and then we snog really
passionately.
It's just passion, isn't it?
Passion
people want passion.
Passion. But no, I think as well, like, if I think people's like view on if you were in a villa, close proximity with your ex, of course you're going to want to go back there. But in many cases, it's not like that.
No.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't know how they dealt with it.
I don't know
honest.
How they did.
I could never. I would have walked. If I was Molly, I'd have walked in and I would have walked straight back out.
Sauntered back out.
Yeah.
There is no chance.
Homer Simpson into the bush.
Yeah.
Back through that door.
Yeah, literally. I don't know how you could handle it. Because as well, irrelevant of how much you're over it or whatever, you are having to watch the person that you used to kiss and wake up with every single day kissing and doing that with somebody else.
I could never.
Yeah, I think your feelings can be like absolutely done, but you like, who wants to watch that? And in what other scenario would you ever have to watch that
never.
In real life?
Never in real life.
Like, I mean, sometimes you might go down a bar or or the club and see her there or whatever, kissing someone else.
Yeah.
But how often is that going to happen compared to every day in the villa?
And they were
and they're just bumping into each other. You just bumped into people there all the time, even if you're trying to avoid people.
Yeah, well, it's
like, sorry.
Even seeing your ex in a club's hard enough, let alone living with them and seeing them with someone else every single day.
Yeah, and they like shower and that.
Yeah.
And, like, you have to watch them brush their teeth.
The speeches, do a nice speech, and you have to listen to them say like nice stuff like to them.
Do you know what? It's a fast track way to really move on. But was there any signs when you were in there that either of you thought, oh, maybe there's a vibe?
I think there was a general. It felt like people thought that Molly might still be into him.
Right.
The other way around. But actually, quite early on, there was like a little bit of a back and forth at the beginning where I think Molly wanted to see how Callum would react to a girl coming in that he fancied. Because there wasn't really anybody in there for Callum at the beginning, right? Mm. Early doors, dawn's crack and that. And she wanted to see how he would react to things. And
yeah.
I think after she saw somebody come in, the whole thing with G, I think she was like, right, okay. Done and
that but was
I think
what
at that
it was.
Point, yeah,
okay,
yeah.
So it was when he actually, because he did go knee deep, roly poly into G.
Took a run up.
He was like, "I am going in. Let's lock it off." And she was like, "Ah,
yeah."
Because she likes the bad boys.
always. She does love a bad boy. She's with the baddest boy now. My toes.
Yeah, your bestie mate. Well, we're going to get into that in a little minute. But Chris, you smooched Molly at the beginning. You snogged a lot of people in there.
I know.
Yeah. Listen.
Why are you so upset about it? No. Why are you so upset? Yeah. You kissed me.
Huh?
You kissed me.
Yeah.
I just like bringing that up. That was it.
Yeah,
that was
I did.
My only point I had to make.
Good for you, girl.
No,
you.
Listen.
Good for you, girl.
Thank you.
Right, everyone in the villa, I'm not going to say the word. I'm going to say pilgrimage instead because I'm sick of the word journey. But you've got to go and do your thing. You've got to kiss people, see if there's anything there. I might have taken it a little bit too far, granted, on a few occasions. But, like, yeah. I got to where I am now, which is single. and sat on a settee.
With me.
With you.
With me. What a great day.
I know. What a great day to be alive.
If I'm honest, if I was to do Love Island, I would snog every person in there just to
well,
get
Well, I was just channeling
it.
Inner Harriet.
Yeah.
Because I know you love snogging.
I love
And you find
snogging.
Out a lot about people when you snog them.
And
particularly when they snog you.
Harriet, I feel like Chris is a good kisser. Am I right?
Yeah. Should we talk about it?
If you want.
Yeah. Yeah. So, obviously, I'm like so... Is it PDA? Is that... I'm not PDA? Yeah.
Oh, my God, I'm
not
PDA. So PDA.
Wait, public... Yeah. So I'm not PDA.
Yeah, I'm very PDA.
Oh, so I'm not. So, like, obviously, when you're in a room with loads of people and then you're kissing, I start getting the giggles. So I'm like, everyone can hear the...
And to be fair, he does a lot of that.
And yeah, and he's
I'm a loud kisser.
Yeah. So I couldn't, like...
I'm just screaming.
Yeah, I started laughing when we were kissing and I was like, you kiss really loud, like that. And then I couldn't take it seriously after that, so we just
I said to her, what do you want me to do? Put the silencer on it? I can't help it. Like, what do you mean? What do I do in that scenario? So basically, every kiss we had in bed ended with her pissing her pants. And then just see, like, oh, yeah. We'll go to sleep.
Do you know what? The start of every good relationship, snog them, and if they don't laugh, you're fucked.
Yeah.
Is that a rule?
Yeah.
I like
that
rule.
I think so. I'm just trying to make you feel better, babe.
Thank you.
You're right.
There was a bit of friction after the kiss with you and Molly with the Callum, because I think Callum was, there was still a bit of a vibe. What was it like from POV Chris to snog Molly and then not snog Molly?
Do you know what it is, right? When you're in there, things happen in a certain order and you don't always have control over the order in which you do things. Mm. There's always an ideal way to do things, but it's very rare that you get to do it that way. In an ideal world, I would have spoke to Callum first. I don't know if I'd have said, it's all right if I kiss your ex for 4 years, but like I would have had a chat with him, but that didn't happen. But he was fine about it.
Yeah.
I told him. And he was all right with it. And I think, like, when I told him and he seemed fine about it, I was like, right, they're definitely done.
Yeah, I did, yeah.
But then I got pied days later from her anyway, so... I think it was the next day, actually.
Aww. It might have been the speech leading up to the kiss.
Oh, not a speech again. What did he say?
What
speech? Not a speech, like
I like facts, all right? Leave me alone.
Is it actual facts?
It's
did
a
you
real
search
fact.
It up before you went in there?
No,
the kind of thing he does.
I listen...
Yeah.
I,
That and he know, you know, listened, on the plane, he was like looking at his notes on his phone.
I listen to a lot of podcasts about facts because I like facts. It's just one of my
favorites. That's what I mean by saying it's the kind of thing you do. You do like knowing things about stuff.
Yeah.
If you didn't know the answer to something, you would find it out.
Yeah.
Whereas I'm like, blissful ignorance for me. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
The edit was pushing really hard for Callum and Molly to get together.
Mm.
How hard did they try to make it happen, the producers?
Not really. Callum and Molly? Callum and Molly?
I'll be honest, right? We haven't seen a lot of episodes towards the end because when you're out in South Africa, they don't give you like the live stream or whatever. We only watch it before we go in or before we do something. But there was a few things where like, obviously people are calling in, the people that they're speaking to on the phone, and they have definitely been briefed. Mention the Callum and Molly thing. Because obviously like making a show for the public want that type of thing.
And I guess it's how they feel. They're just encouraging them to say it. Like,
Well,
if you think that, you should definitely say it.
Yeah, briefing calls, they're not going to be putting words in their mouth, but they'll be saying, what are your thoughts on this? And then obviously all of the public were saying it. So like, yeah, that would have been, they would have been, all right, go with that then type of thing. So
it kind of got in Tom's head, didn't it?
So maybe the editing side of things, but when I was actually in there, they didn't.
No, very different vibes on the inside.
Because I think that's why Molly and Callum were so shocked.
Confused.
They were like, because for them, it was like done.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it was done by the end of the first week.
Really?
For them. There was like no going back from then on in, I think.
And what do you think about Tom and Molly on the outside?
I think it could work. I think it genuinely could work. I think it could. I'm just trying to think.
Do you think it could work?
Yeah.
All right, cool.
I think it would last. But I do think, I mean, I'm just taking it from like a personal experience. Like if I was in the villa with my ex-boyfriend And then I come out. I don't know. I think they might rekindle.
Callum and Molly.
I think that's what people want, isn't it? Do you reckon? They were
the
talking...
The world would implode.
They were talking about walking the dogs together on the outside.
Also, or... Tom and Callum are friends. Like,
yeah, yeah, they're best mates.
That's bizarre.
I think Tom asked Callum for a lot of advice about Molly. Imagine
well,
how weird
sense.
That would be.
That makes sense.
Oh, bro, do you know your ex? Like, what type of teddy bears does she like? Because it's Valentine's
Day. No, nothing's
Day.
As bad as when Casey came in and had to ask Tom,
don't.
Can I speak to Molly? And Tom went, yeah, go on.
That is an ick for me. I'm not going to lie.
What?
If I...
Before?
Like, Tom... Tom, well, both of them, I guess. But Tom saying yes is just... It's like, there's like bros before hoes, and then there's like, are you joking?
But
like,
this is why the villa girls, is so weird. True. But this is why the villa is so weird. It's yeah. like you're like accepting like things that you wouldn't accept on the outside. It's the oddest.
Yeah.
Bizarre. And I kind of saw it as Tom being like, give it a go if you want, mate.
Like, maybe it's because he
go
knew.
And test it.
Yeah. That is quite cool. No, it's more of an ick for me because I just think it would make me, as if I was Molly, be like, oh. Because she did kind of react like that. She was kind of like, and listen, he seems like a lovely boy and they seem very, very happy together. So slay for them. Georgia H and Anton came fifth. Was it surprising to see them below Toby and Georgia S after all the drama earlier in the series? Slash, was it confusing to see them below Callum and Jess, who had only been together for 5.5 minutes?
Personally, I don't think so. I think when we all went back into the villa and we made the boats, I think we kind of like... led people. Obviously, people were seeing what they're seeing on the outside.
Yeah.
But a lot of the reasons that were given for Anton and Georgia H as well were like reflected in the outside world, I think, from my perspective anyway. Mm. And I think like their journey was a weird one, I think. I don't know whether, from my perspective, I don't necessarily believe in it. But I would love to be proved wrong.
Yeah.
I'd love to see it because they're both, I love them both like individually.
Yeah.
But I can't see it from what I've seen on the inside. Their
and it's also like everybody looks at them, everyone looks at it like from their own perspective. So it's like, would I want to be in something that's similar? No.
Yeah.
And so if that's the case, then maybe that's directing your opinion.
I think they just butt heads too much.
Yeah.
They're not, I don't think they're on the same wavelength with a lot of things.
But
do you know what I mean?
A lot of married couples butt heads.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, after 40 years of marriage, not 2 weeks in a villa.
True. Yeah, but imagine how much time we all spend with each other in there.
I know.
24
intense,
hours. Like in a marriage, you go to work, you like fish around, like you go out, you go, not fish around, but
fish around for what?
No, I don't know. Fish around. I don't know. But you go shopping, and then you come back. Oh, hi, how's your day been? You know, that kind of vibe.
What are you talking about, Joanna? You know,
I'm the one that's had no sleep, and she's chatting the most shit.
She's like, anyway, so you go shopping. What's this got to do with Georgia S and Anton?
I get the point she's making. Yeah. Like, we're together all the time in there. There's a lot going on. It's intense. In real life, you don't see your other half every second of every day.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank God I'm here.
Okay. Sorry.
Thank you.
Yeah, I see what you mean. I agree. And I think... I always just love, because it's over now, it's like, let's just see what happens.
That's the thing. Let's see what happens. I don't think Georgia H was too happy with Anton at the final.
No.
Because he said, I can't remember exactly what he said, but he said something.
He said something that she didn't like. Yeah. And I think that definitely caused... And also, I think remembering that it's... Everyone was obviously really nervous. You could tell that people were really nervous at the final.
Oh, it's so nerve-wracking. Like, even just seeing that many, like, people in the villa.
Yeah.
And it's live,
Yeah.
But even us going back into the villa to do the voting, we were all so nervous. Like,
Really? Yeah. Why do you think that was?
I think it's when you come out of the bubble and then you go back in. What?
No, go on, yeah.
So I was shaking so much because I don't like making these decisions. But obviously, if I was in the villa the whole time, it wouldn't feel as bad. But when you go back in there, you have to make a decision. It's actually like really scary. My legs were shaking so much. Chris and Joe put their knees behind my legs to keep my legs from shaking. Same happened with Hannah. Same happened with Demi. Like, it was literally like we were all shaking.
Everyone was cacking the pants. The funny thing was as well, when we went in, like the production team or like the execs or whatever were like, right, stern, don't crack a smile.
Oh yeah, that was making me laugh.
It was so hard because they're all on the terrace like, way! Like, I don't know what they were saying, like just shouting random stuff. And they shout your name and you're like, oh God, look. It's like you've got to like focus. Yeah. That was really
That's
hard.
The first time I've seen you looking stern for like more than 3 seconds in my life. Whole life.
In my life.
Yeah. Oh. Going back to that day when you went back in, honestly, live for the organized drama for me. But I will say people got pretty pissy about the people you voted for.
Mm.
Like it was pretty like, it certainly wasn't like, no worries. Like I would say more so you, Joanna, like when you voted for Arabella, yeah. She was not a happy bunny about that, was she?
No. And I think I did speak to her after about it when we were in like the holding villa before going into the main villa for the final. And I just said, you know, like, I actually didn't see any of the episodes where they were in the hideaway, her and Adam. Yeah. I didn't see any of that because obviously we didn't have our phones as well, like while we were in South Africa and stuff. And I do think, like, for me, it's why are you smiling?
Sorry,
again?
I'm trying not to.
I can't.
Don't keep going.
Stop. I was on a row.
I'm not. I was just looking at her.
I was on a row. So obviously, but for me, it was really hard because I'd seen the journeys of the other couples and stuff. So it was really hard to be like, okay, like, you know, this couple that I've not even seen much about because obviously I've not watched the episodes and stuff, to put them through compared to the others, it was really hard for me. So if it sounds individual people, like Arabella's name would not be on my board, but we spoke about it afterwards. We kind of like cleared the air a little bit. And yeah, and it just felt like, yeah, it's just really difficult.
Mm. Yeah.
I was so nervous.
Yeah, do you know what made it worse as well? Basically, at first, no one was responding. So Mitch got up, somebody else got up, I got up, and then they came over to Tannoy and went, you know that you can talk back to the Islanders, by the way. You can, like, clap back if you want. And that's when everyone started clapping back.
And I thought,
however, Anton and Georgia were like, yeah, do you know what? It's fine. We get it. They took it really well. So that made your situation way worse.
Yeah. Because I said to you in your ear, I was like, oh, my God, this is going to, like, this is not going to go
well. So I got away with it. No one said anything to me. But then after me, like, everybody who voted for Arabella and Adam got a little bit of, had a little bit of a to and fro.
Do you think it might be fairly similar to when you guys were in the game and you were getting steamrolled by everybody voting for you? And it's like,
we both did a deep breath. We're like,
but you know what I mean? Like, it's a similar vibe to when you guys were in that situation where people kept saying your name over and over again. And although it's not personal because it's a game, it feels personal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you think it's similar?
It is similar in concept, but I don't think anyone really has any idea how bad that was because it was literally like, I don't know how many rounds you'd have seen. We did 12.
Mm. We didn't see that many.
There was 12 questions. Every person there had one question for every person there, and it was 12 of us.
And it was savage
and
questions.
And every round was me and Joanna.
Yeah.
Non-stop.
Yeah.
And we just got to the point where, like, we just had to say, listen, just ignore it, like, move on. Just say thank you and move. Thank you for your feedback and move.
Yeah, we actually just started thanking them, like, thank you so much, thank you. But then obviously, then it just got like, I started thinking, oh my God, how hypocritical that some of the people were like saying certain things. I'm thinking, you had the same journey as us. I'm like, how can you sit there and say, so does that mean that if we're not compatible, that means they're not compatible?
Yeah,
and that's what we were like arguing in our head, weren't we?
It was the roguest thing, the roguest things as well, like just everything, sexual chemistry, compatibility. We were just scapegoats.
Like last on the outside.
Like last on the outside. We were just the easy answer for everything.
Did we get the cheat one? Cheat? No, one-sided?
No, you didn't get
cheat. One-sided, we got that.
Yeah, one-sided. Yeah. Yes.
My baby.
It was a tough day at the office, I'm not going to lie.
I was like, I'm not going to lie, because obviously we're very good friends, so watching that was hard for me to see the emotion that you... But also, I've got to say, the way that you held yourself and looking after Joanna was very... Big slave from you.
Thank you.
Because you were saying, Joanna, to me before the show that you're not an emotional person, like you don't cry very easily.
No.
So the fact that you got to that point shows the pressure of the situation.
Well, people like DM me going like, or even like some of the comments would be, why is she crying? It's not even that deep. But because they didn't see it all. Like it was ruthless.
That was like round 9.
Yeah.
And we still had like 3 rounds to go after she cried. And we still just had to take it.
Like my makeup was all down my face.
Every single thing that was turned around was our name.
Oh my God.
And the thing about the situation, the reason I was defending her so hard is because like, it wasn't really about me a lot of the time. It was because Joanna had started speaking to Callum, which we'd basically discussed. And I said, listen, do your thing. You've got to do your journey in here. Like you've got to pilgrimage. You've got to do it the same way that I'd done it. It just so happened that I'd done it in the first couple of weeks. And then she'd come in.
Yeah.
That's the timing thing. And I'm like...
Such bad timing.
Was there any specific couple that you think really came for you and you felt affronted by?
Probably, no, do you know what? It's Anton. Anton.
Well, not. It wasn't even really Georgia, was it?
No, it was Anton was pretty much making the decisions. And when I
Which is interesting because he, out of everyone, is the one that has had that friend. But he was actually friend-zoned completely. Yeah. And then it was reversed.
And I think it was when he was saying our name, he was smirking every time. And I thought everyone else, when they had our names down, despite like whether they used us as like sort of like a cop-out or whether it wasn't, that you can tell they still had a bit of like, oh, like, we feel bad, but we've got to put someone down. He was just smirking every time. And I was like, and that was winding me up. And you looked at me and went, don't kick off. And I was like, I was literally
Yeah, but I think, you know, it's like when you're in that heightened emotional state, you could have said or done things that you didn't like mean.
That's what I was saying. Not to do, because it could have gone really sad.
Yeah. And is that because realistically you were telling yourself the same thing?
Yes.
Yeah. But that's a good thing. I think that's a good thing. It's like, I know that I feel like I'm ready to kick off.
Yeah.
So if do you know what I mean? Like, don't you do it either. Because you're just going to feel silly about ourselves.
It was weird because I actually did kick off a bit towards the end, but the way they edited it looked like really mental.
Yeah, because it did look like the boys went from naught to raging at you.
Yeah.
And it's like,
no, it's because we were having an argument, but they just cut my calm bit in. Didn't make any sense.
Yeah. I think in that scenario, anyone would have been riled up. And I think you both dealt with it really well. And also, I'm just going to say, we're going to, in a minute, deep dive into the couples, but I've got to say, like, I do see a sexual chemistry vibe between you guys.
The thing is that, like, even in the villa, we weren't just like, we wasn't like away from each other. We spent a lot of time together in there, like cuddling, or even like when we were just like playing games.
We
on
had
our phone.
Big debriefs in there as well every night before bed.
Yeah, like just
what kind of stuff did you talk about?
Like we got deep.
Yeah, loads.
Not
of
like
stuff.
That, Harriet. You dirty.
Yeah.
No, we got like really like vulnerable in front of each other, really, in bed, didn't we? Because
exactly.
Easy bed. Because we haven't like actually spent any time together, just me and Joe, yet.
Yeah.
Which is crazy when you think about it.
Yeah.
Apart from literally in bed. So, yeah, we're just like, yeah, we just got deep in that.
Were you
so
annoying deep, everyone deep by being like,
oh, they,
all night?
Callum picked up one night, didn't they?
Yeah. Because you speak really loud. He puts these earplugs in when he sleeps, but he talks to me while the earplugs are in. And I'm like,
I haven't got an indoor voice.
Should we talk about when you were sleep talking every night?
Oh my God, you do sleep talk
loudly
every night.
Because of the earplugs, I was like shouting it.
So what kind of stuff was he saying?
But no one knows what I was saying.
So one time he sat up and went, oh, the penguins.
Penguins.
The penguins. And I can't remember what else he said to that. And I went, Chris, because then Callum turned around as well. And he was like, why is he shouting? And I was going like, shh, like, stop shouting. And you went, did I just say about penguins? And I went, yeah, and you went, oh, and they just went back to sleep. They have to get them clips or something and send them to you. And then there was another time where you were obviously, I don't know how to say this, like being in another bed on a Saturday.
Oh, you can say that.
Oh, yeah, so like on Saturdays, the boys and girls can't be in the same bed, so we have to split up. Yeah.
We know that.
Oh, okay, perfect. And then I looked over because I heard you talking and he was sitting up just sleep talking. And I was like, so odd.
Was that part of your decision to maybe get a little bit of the ick, Joanna? Because you were like, I don't know if I can live with that.
Oh, all that stuff I'm doing unconsciously whilst I'm asleep. Yeah, sorry about
that. Maybe I love it about you.
I feel like that's something Georgia Harrison would say. He sleeps talks. So.
Do you know why we get on really well? Because in bed, we have slept in bed together quite a few times. We probably talk to each other because I also sleep talk in my sleep.
We also listen to Harry Potter audiobooks.
Yeah, big time.
Sleep.
That's odd. The audiobooks.
No, that's
Harry
her
Potter.
Thing. That's not me. That's
really?
Her thing.
Are you coming for me, Joanna?
No.
Are you coming for me? I'm going
to
start crying now.
Any more than she already is?
No, but how are you going to listen to like spells being said? And
are you
stuff
joking?
While
hello,
Lamora,
I'm like this.
Oh, it's Stephen Fry, though.
No.
Stephen Fry.
Like, oh, and then
what's
Harry.
One of the spells called?
And then Harry.
Hermione.
Joanna, while don't knock it till you tried it, sweetie.
Never. It's not a thing.
It is a thing. It's a massive thing.
That.
It's the world's
How
biggest franchise.
How did you feel, babe, by the way, not listening to anything when you were in the villa?
Struggled, but there was enough, you know, kissing noises.
Okay, we're going to deep dive into the couples now. Who do we think can actually go the distance? We're going to do the finalists. So let's start with Anton and Georgia H. You've already...
I just started a couple of weeks.
Cool.
Mitch said on TikTok yesterday they probably already broke off.
Mitch really.
I hope they last though. I do hope they last.
I think I give him a couple of months.
Oh, okay.
I give him a couple
That's
of
generous
months.
Of you, Joanna.
Yeah. I'm gonna be
You are kind like that.
Yeah.
Though. Yeah.
Yeah.
Toby and Georgia S.
I genuinely, from the bottom of my heart, think they are going to work.
Forever.
We've seen their whole thing. Potentially.
Is this going to be another Tommy Fury and Molly?
Could be.
Potentially.
Because they've been through a lot, and I'm not going to say the word, but they have.
They're
trauma bonded now.
No, honestly.
They are.
That's not great.
No, I know, but they are.
Think probably, maybe, could I go as far to say the biggest chance of success?
I think they will last the longest out of everyone, if not forever.
Okay.
And we're going to be at their wedding, like...
Yeah.
Yeah.
What are you going to be like, Joanna?
I'll tell you why. I know this, because they were both talking about they wanted us four to go on holiday together.
So that's when you know
to Disneyland,
that's
Florida.
You.
They brought that up, not me. Although I did suggest Disneyland.
Can you believe he's not been to Disneyland yet?
I know. I was a deprived child.
You are born to be at Disneyland.
Yeah. Oh, I know. I used to go on caravan holidays.
You were born at Disneyland. Like,
that's... I've been to Disneyland in my later years.
Oh, yeah, but I'm ready for it now.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm
I feel like as well...
I get on the rides
You're
now.
Tall enough to get on
yeah,
the rides.
Isn't it? Yeah, like, just.
No, your hair gives you the height.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm actually 5 foot four without my hair.
Anyway, right. Moving on.
Sorry.
Josh and Sophie.
Love them.
I love them. I think at least a year...
I think he's sweeter than he...
He is deep down a lovely boy. He just won't admit it.
Yeah.
He won't show it. It's all facade, but he is a lovely boy deep down. I reckon, 12 months.
Yeah, I think a month. I think a month? I mean...
Really flipped on that.
A year, I mean. I think at least a year.
Yeah,
and then
potentially
if they make
longer.
It to a year, then we know it's going to be in full swing.
When's the first off-ramp thing? Is it like 7 months, is it, or something?
Six.
Is it 6 months?
Yeah.
Halfway. 6 or 7 months, I reckon.
Yeah.
Is what you wear. It's like the first hurdle.
Yeah.
6 or 7 months, then I reckon a year and a half, and then you're set.
Yeah.
Because it's like every you get to know someone sort of every 6 months, you get to know them another level.
What's the word for that? There's a word for it, isn't there?
Not I wouldn't know.
Itch, the itch.
I'm single.
Seven-month itch and the year and a half itch.
Yeah, but I got dumped at 2.5 years, so what happened there?
I can't tell you, Joanna, but we can deep dive into it now if you'd
probably
like.
Probably him. Blame him.
No, but I think there's no mathematical equation that fits it, but I think there's like a normal level of... Like 6 months for an early starter, I think, is when you start to get, you know.
Yeah.
Mm.
Right.
It's emotional.
Jess and Callum.
I love Callum. I love Jess.
Yes, I love both of them.
I just don't know. See, the thing is with Callum, he said to me early on, I said to him, oh, what about the twins then? And he said, nah, they were on my season. I just can't see it that way. And then he ended up with Jess.
Yeah.
So obviously his feelings have changed in that, but I don't know. I just don't know. Like, I reckon they'll see it for a few months.
I think they'll have fun together. I think they're going to go off and have some fun.
Darling, what does that mean?
Whatever you think.
Do you know what I mean? Like, they're going to just kiki a bit.
They're going to just have some fun.
Yeah. Like, I don't know how serious
it is. Just wine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know how serious it is. I think they're just going to have fun because they've only known each other 4.5 minutes.
Mm.
So, okay. And then the final couple is our winners, Tommy and Molly. Tommy?
Oh,
I keep doing that. Tommy and Molly.
Yeah. Because it is Tommy and Molly. Tom and Molly.
Did you want to speak?
No, go for it.
I do have high hopes that, I don't know, I like the storyline of Molly and Callum getting back together. But if they don't, I do see like Tom and Molly at least a couple years, 3 years, 2-3 years. Yeah, because they do really get along.
They give, it's serving long term, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah.
It's giving long term.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'd hope so.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I don't know.
And what
it's different, like in there is it's a cool environment to get to know people, but on the outside there's a lot of different challenges.
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
But I just
I hope they do.
Yeah.
3 years. We'll lock in 3 years.
Let's lock in 3 years.
Okay. Locked in.
Yeah.
What is this locked off? Locked in. Can't
basically when you get asked sometimes you get can I say this? Probably not.
Right.
When you get asked who you're voting for in something, sometimes they'll go, right, that's locked in.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that makes
sense. And then, you can go rogue, because they can't stop you, but...
Like Toby?
No, Toby would have locked that in, I think.
Really? No, because remember when he did the last minute, oh, I'm picking Georgia, and he wasn't going to... That was not what he'd locked in his brain for who's picking in the recoupling.
Oh, yeah, maybe.
Do you know what I mean? Don't trust that guy for being locked in. But he is locked off.
He's locked off now. So what is that then? Is that like...
Locked off is the stage... Girlfriend, boyfriend. No, it's the stage before girlfriend and boyfriend and after exclusive.
Why are we inventing stages? Like, it's complicated enough.
Yeah, that's
because
not...
I find sometimes when you put the label on boyfriend and girlfriend, it just goes...
Yeah, okay.
Well, my experience is anyway.
What, on that note, my other favourite couple in the villa... Chris and Joanna. Oh. What's going on there?
You're cute.
You're cute. Take it away.
What is going on here, Joanna?
Why are you asking me?
Throwing it to
you're
you.
Half the half ladies couple. First.
Yeah, you are 50% of this.
You're half the problem. No, so...
I will say we've been flirting aggressively for the last day or so. Maybe longer, actually.
Why aggressively?
I don't know. It's probably the wrong word.
That sounds like...
Flirting a lot.
Yeah. Do you know what it is? We're just like, we've not had our phones much. We've only just cut, it's our first day back in London. I think we're just gonna...
We've never actually spent time together on our own.
Yeah.
It's always been people looking at us.
Just so like right now.
Yeah. Right, literally right now, yeah.
So I think it's just like, just gauging it as now that we're back and we've got our phones now. Are we gonna go for lunch?
We're going for lunch after, apparently. Just ask me on a date on Under the Duvet.
Exclusive, everybody. They're going on a date straight after the show.
Oh, my God.
She makes all the first moves.
And that is a slay from you.
Yeah, thank you.
I respect it
thank
a lot.
Sexy, sexy moves.
But it makes it easy for me because I don't have to start coming up with stupid ways to kiss people.
Yeah. Yeah, because that would have been another ick.
Well, exactly. Mm. Worked out
another right. ick. We're going to get into that in a sec.
However, oh, this jacket's hot. However, you know, we mentioned about the final.
Go on.
About the Super Mario thing, race course. Yeah. They actually messaged us.
Yeah, they've already messaged us.
And they want us to go down.
Oh my God, there's a Super Mario race course.
Yeah.
Well, I'm coming on this date.
I think it's just a virtual reality one.
No, I want the official
one.
Yeah, because then you go and pick up all like the shells and stuff.
If it's not Mario Kart, I don't want
it. Yeah, guys, I'm coming, so that's fine.
You're coming with us.
You and me and our friend Steve.
Yeah. Try and have it in the morning.
That'll be me. I can't wait to be a thruple with you guys. neither of you seemed happy about the vote from the Islanders that sent you and Joe home, Joanna.
Oh, God.
Tell me how that was, POV, from your side.
Awful. Because 5 years ago, I got voted out the same way. And for me, it was like, when someone's saying, like... So 5 years ago, they were like, oh, who do you think should, like, have another chance of love? And I thought, well, Michael's had, like... three now, or two. And so I thought, I've only had one. So I thought, oh, maybe they'll give me that chance. Didn't give me it. And then this time round, obviously, like, in Tom's speech, he was like, oh, we're just, like, wondering, like, who is deserving of a second chance.
Mm.
And then they came for me. I don't know. I personally don't know how that was worked out.
I'll tell you what happened.
Go on.
Tell me.
So basically, there was obviously a lot of people in this season that have got best mates that have come in from the outside. They've got alliances and that. So that whole voting mechanism was so skewed towards people who already had mates in there.
Mm.
So basically, the twins couldn't be voted for. Casey couldn't be voted for because obviously Sophie was sat down. Tom was sat down. So they're covered. Molly's close with Arabella. So she wasn't getting voted for. So it only really left Joe and Joe. You couldn't vote the same couple. There had to be separate couples. It had to be girl, boy. So it was either me and Arabella voted out or Joe and Joe voted out. And there couldn't be any other way of doing it.
But what I don't...
So that's how it went down.
Yeah, I don't get though, because obviously then we had...
Essentially, they weren't thinking about it from like who, like the Love Island, like what we're here to do, to find love and go to the outside world with somebody. They were thinking about it from who they want to save for their mates. That's what happened.
Which is life, I guess. But I just felt frustrated because I was like... When I watched it, I was like, well, if you're going to do that, you might as well vote out Chris and Joanna. And you're my mate. And I was like, I don't want to see him.
They couldn't. We're in the same couple. They weren't allowed to do that.
Oh, you weren't allowed to vote out one couple?
Had to be separate
from a separate couple.
Oh, that wasn't made clear on the show at all.
Okay, it was,
That was not the vibe. Like, we assumed that is bazonkers to me.
Yeah.
Sorry, I did not. You've given me new information there.
Brand new information. Yeah.
Can I say also, I would say... I do want to make it clear that I think if you two had stayed in, I think there could have been, a different story. I do truly think it could be a different story. And I also feel bad.
Weigh in on that.
What do you mean by that?
Just throw your thoughts out there.
No, yeah, 100%. And do you know what was... 100%. No, and I did say, it was really weird, because like during the game, I was like, the amount you stuck up for me, I was like, do you know what? Like, I felt like at that point, just going, like, scrap any other connections, just like, obviously stick with... Not stick with you, but like, kind of like... Just because...
Finally, she admits
No,
it.
Just because I thought, my God, like, someone to stick up for me like that, that's a lot. And even, like, my dad, like, put in my family group chat, apparently, like, oh, he's got my, like, approval sort of thing, because... And my dad don't approve many people anyway. He's very, like...
Has he ever approved?
Yeah.
Okay.
But, no, but it's taken a while. But even, like, when I came home and he picked me up from the airport, he went, like, that boy stuck up for you a lot. That boy stuck up for you. So, to
he
hear my dad
said integrity,
that,
didn't he?
I don't know.
Me a man of integrity.
Is that what he said?
I don't know. You told me. Yeah, I think so.
I know my sister said that on FaceTime.
Sorry. I think this is so sweet. So,
but then obviously I didn't get the opportunity to then even turn around and go like, oh, this is a situation now. So that's what is a bit gutting, annoying to be obviously out and stuff.
Listeners and watchers, how raging are we? Because I would have been a lot more excited had you two been in the final. I'm not going to lie.
Well, here's another piece of information you won't know. I obviously got taken out of the villa the next day because I was like, guys, what's the point?
Mm.
9 days, you've just taken Joanna out. Like, what am I going to do?
Yeah.
And I said to production, put Joanna back in. And then I think you said to production, put me back in.
Yes.
But we said it at two separate times and I'd already been given the chop. I'd already been voted out before she said it. So there could have been a world where she came back in. And the only reason that I was like, do I leave, do I not? The only reason I was thinking about potentially staying is if they might have put her back in. But then when Adam walked in, I was like, that's not Joanna.
That's Although they do look so similar. So I'm surprised
guy.
You weren't like confused.
There was a moment where I was double taking.
Yeah, is it? No.
Yeah, no.
Well, I'm smiling a lot because this is really cute information. Your dad approves. I approve. So
you got the main approval.
Yeah, I am probably genuinely the most important person to impress in
actually.
His.
She's my friend now.
Right, I won't go that far, babe.
No, you've but you're at the picture.
You've got
I would just say I'm
go.
The scariest person to impress because
no,
I'm
I'd
the one.
Say so. Yeah. I would say so.
Oh well, you've got my absolute approval. I'm not going to lie. Let's talk a little bit about friendships in the villa for you two.
Oh yeah.
So you were really good friends with Toby and Kaz in the villa.
Yeah.
Kind of had a little friendship thruple.
Yeah, we had a nice little platonic triangle going on.
What was that like from your side?
It was really nice. You need it in there. It's very important to have friends. I felt like I was Toby's older brother, but then maybe like Kaz's younger brother somehow.
She's really
Kaz
mature.
Kaz is very emotionally mature, and she's wise. She's very, very wise.
She's a cool girl, man.
Yeah, she gave a lot in there, like... of herself to other people, which I respect a lot. Like, she wasn't having the best time in there, but she still had everyone's back type thing. And I respected her for that. And then, Toby, I mean, on the first day we started chatting, we were talking about cabbages for 45 minutes straight, and I was just like, I love this guy.
Don't know how you could talk about cabbages for that long, but
one night, we were waiting for G and Joanna to come back from the beach hut because they were doing ads in the beach hut.
Oh, yeah.
And we laid up in bed together. This is when we had to sleep in the same bed. We were talking about Pokemon for about 2 hours straight, the most intense Pokemon conversation that's ever happened in history.
you are a very intense boy, though.
Thank you.
a positive thing,
though. Yeah, in a nice way. We're basically waiting for these two to come back. We were like waiting up for the girls.
Oh, yeah, and then I threw my bra at you walking past, and then Georgia threw my bra into the bed with them.
And I slept with it on my head.
Can I just say, that is the energy of the... you have met your match, because that is the kind of thing that you would do to her.
Throw my pants up.
Yeah. Like, that's good vibes from you, because you're giving weird Chris energy, which I love.
But he walked past and it was in the dark and I was like, should I throw it now, Julia? She's like, and I threw it and you went, ha! Do you know what it was?
Yeah, I pooed my pants.
I'd love it if a girl threw a bra at me. But anyway, moving on. Chris, you actually made Toby cry when you left.
Yeah, no, I seen him at the final and he said he'd cried most days since as well. So at least I'm not making girls cry.
Yeah. Hey, win-win.
Yeah.
Joanna, who were you closest with in the villa?
To be fair, I was close with all the girls. I think I really grew close with Arabella and, of course, I've always been close with Georgia. So, but then even Molly, we were really close in there. That's one thing I loved about this season and this year. It was like all the girls were so close. Mm. No matter what the... like, if there was, like, a bit of animosity at some point, you'd squash it and be absolutely fine in the dressing room. Like, no one's made to feel uncomfortable. Like, it was such a nice environment to be around in.
That's good to hear as well, I think. What were the the kind of behind the scenes bits that we didn't see, the kooky wooky stuff that went on? Because I know Hannah and Mitch were saying about how Hannah used to rap all the time and make up songs.
Yeah.
So what stuff can, what tea can you spill?
Oh, there's loads of, like, you were rubbing me off about the speech in there. So I gave this speech that I thought out, and it was like the When Harry Met Sally speech, but I made it specific to Joanna.
This is the one she got the ick about.
Yeah, and yeah. I did that right, and I said the whole thing, and I did it all right. I was a bit nervous, but I did it all right. But what they do over the tannoy during the speeches that everybody hates is you'll give a speech and you'll just, they'll be deathly silent, and then they'll go, elaborate. And then you have to dome it. You have to come up with it off your head. You know what I'm like? When I get panicky, I get sarcastic.
Yeah.
So I'm like talking about levitating around the villa, dancing on rainbows and stuff like that.
And what's four walls? Parallel walls, you said?
No, that was something else. I said you light up every room that you walk into, including rooms parallel to that room, which is just a good way of saying
it. Honestly, I'm not going to lie. I was into the speech because I'm weird.
Yeah.
So I would love if someone was talking about parallel rooms. Yeah. I want to not understand what you're saying, but I want to feel the energy.
I haven't seen it, but I don't know if they showed it. But like, I got so sarcastic to the point where I was kind of saying like, and something to do with it going on for forever and ever. And then because I said it like that, I just went, amen. And everyone cracked up laughing. I was like, why have I just fucking said that? But you just panicked.
So basically, it was a cute speech and then it turned insane because you kept having to elaborate.
Because they said elaborate.
Yeah.
And they do that all the time.
Right.
And that's like the Messy Mitch speech that got really bad, where he was like, talking to you is like looking in a mirror. And what else did he say? Time flies, but I don't know what the time is. That was because he'd done a speech and they went,
elaborate.
Elaborate. If you say elaborate to anybody in the villa, they will get PTSD.
I was going to say, are you triggered by the word elaborate?
It is the worst thing. And I spoke to Lewis, the exec, about it, and I know exactly why he does it, because he wants people to kind of like panic a little bit and just say stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
And that is exactly what happens. So you can no longer have me off about that, because you knew I was under the cosh.
Now I do.
You were there.
Yeah,
you heard Lewis go,
you're
elaborate.
You're such a confident person. I thought, oh, he's going to smash it.
Yeah,
in the second half, I was like, what's a parallel? What do you mean parallel room? What?
I also have quite bad anxiety, though. That's why I plan things in my head. So
yeah, but I didn't know that, of course.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
We're learning about
it. Joe, elaborate.
Elaborate. So even that just makes your heart drop. It's so weird.
Yeah.
But I would say, like, a funny behind the scenes was, like, people think that, like, even our walk-in when we went and we're doing the voting and things like that, that you just walk in once. We filmed that 20 times, like the walk up and down into the villa so they can get all the clips of everyone. Being next to Chris is not ideal when you're trying to be like sexy or serious and stuff like that, because
he's tripping over in slow motion.
He was walking like this, like, and I went, how are you doing your arms like that? And then I was like, right. And I was like, don't look. I was like, I'm not going to look. And then I didn't realise the camera had moved there. So I'm walking and going, Chris, just don't laugh. Don't make a sound. Like, just keep going. He was like, the camera's on you. And I was like, okay, well, that's not going to be used then.
She goes, where's the camera? And it was on her when she said it, so I couldn't say it. But you literally do that so many times.
Yeah.
And I realised I could keep a straight face whilst going, just trying to distract them.
So I was
but it's
laughing.
Boring otherwise, you're just walking.
Yeah, the majority of the time I was laughing, so probably only got probably 2 or 3 clips of me being serious out of the 20.
They got your
walk.
Ass in it?
Yeah, they got my bum in it, which is really good. I've been working on that for a while, so I'm like,
hey,
happy.
And that is, do you know what? I feel you on that, because I've been working on mine, and so when I get a nice ass shot, it's a real play.
Don't take that phrase the wrong way.
Yeah.
This feels like school.
No, it is, though, but you regress. You become a child because you've got an authority like above you now. They're telling you to do things.
Yeah.
And you all turn into, like, you outside the head teacher's office with your best mate waiting to get a bollock in, like, all the time.
Yeah.
We got told off so much. Like, obviously, pretty much everybody in there has got ADHD, right?
Yeah.
And we have to sit there silently for, like, 10, 15 minutes at a time every single thing, every single recoupling, 10, 15 minutes at a time. We're all just like this.
And, like, legs go in.
And, like, legs go in and, like, people are trying to fidget in that. And, like, literally, you look over, you catch someone's eye and you're gone.
Yeah.
Like, you have to leave the circle and, like get your head straight and come back in.
Oh, you had to do that once. Remember that? You had to walk off and, like, it was around the
like, production will come in and go, do you want to have 5 minutes? Because you'll get into a giggling fit.
Yeah.
And you literally can't help it. But it's a really serious moment and everyone's like, somebody's going home, but you're literally just absolutely pissing
weeing your pants.
Laughing.
Yeah. Did you wee your pants at any time when you were in there from laughter?
No.
I had to think about it, though.
No.
I had to think about it.
I haven't weed my pants.
Ever?
When I was young, yeah.
No, I've let a bit of wee out in the last probably 5 years of laughing. Let a bit of wee out.
Not like
fully
a lot
pissed
of
myself.
Wee,
yeah, like a little bit of wee has come out. Yeah.
Are we talking actual vision?
A little dribble.
Yeah, like a little, like you're laughing so much and you really need to pee.
I dribble all the time.
Are you
time.
Talking about like a metaphor for weeing? Like no, need no. To wee, or actually weeing, like the actual,
being
actual very, visual
talking about
drip.
Actually weeing.
Very literal. Yeah. No.
Well, you obviously you haven't spent enough time with me and Chris. So we're going to make you piss your pants.
That's what we do.
Yes.
Final one before we go on to pillow talk is why is there so much history between Love Islanders and why can't... Because I noticed that you don't speak about people outside of the show.
Mm.
But it must be difficult when everybody seems to have snogged everybody.
Yeah, it's not that we don't speak about people outside the show. It's that we can't mention names. So as soon as you say a name, they can't include it.
Right.
Because they don't have any right to respond. Well, okay. They can't respond, can they?
Yeah.
So yeah, we did talk about people because obviously when you're in there, there's like the full context, which is us talking to each other, and then the subcontext that goes on TV. Mm. Obviously, you see snippets of it, but like we've got to give the other person like the full background. Otherwise, we're just, you know, just like missing big snippets of our life out.
Yeah, but also I've been friends with you for a long time and like, I don't think you've dated that many Love Islanders, but it appears that everyone else has. Like,
because I haven't either.
Have you not?
No.
Because like, it felt like everyone in there, like Georgia literally...
Just one for me, I think.
Yeah, Georgia had like dated a few and I think some of the others, Casey's dated a few. Like, I was shocked by how... incestuous it is.
Very incestuous, yeah.
And it's weird, like, even like when you kiss in a challenge, like, it's just like, oh, you just kissed in a challenge. It's so weird. Like, we're on the outside. If you've done, like, I don't know, like, truth or dare when you're with your friends, if that's still a thing that people do, you'd be like, oh my God, I can't have just kissed him. But in there, it's like a job. It's
so
weird.
Normal. Yeah, it's that's so actually odd. What a lot of people have said when they've come out. Like, I think Joe was saying that last week, like, it's not a thing. You're like kissing, so it's like, oh, we just kiss and then we also have breakfast.
It's part of the job title.
Behind the scenes on the games, like you see little bits of it, but everybody looks at each other and just goes, it's just the game before we start. Obviously it doesn't always get taken like that, but what we're basically saying is like, let's do this right.
I do feel kind of jealous. I just want to stick my tongue in a couple of people's mouths for no reason.
Well, me and Toby, we were talking about early on in the show, we were like, the best thing, the best dare you can get, the dream, we'd call it, but just refer to it as the dream. The best dare you can get is to snog all of the Girl Islanders.
Yeah.
And then somebody gave him it on one of the challenges and it was our joint dream and he got to do it.
Oh, good
so
for
whilst
him.
Whilst he's in bed with me, his dream is to snog all the Girl
You hadn't
Islanders.
Even come in at this point. This was like week two.
So we asked a lot of the ex-Islanders what it would take them to go back in, why they went back in.
Mm.
Tom, I believe, said he would go back in for a price of a Prada bag.
Okay.
What did Demi say? Oh, she was like, oh, you'd get one of those in your first week.
Yeah.
But I want to know, what was the price for you guys to go back in the villa?
Just love.
Just absolute love.
No, genuinely, like, love. You get to meet people that are of, like, they have the same life as you.
Mm-hmm.
And there's not many opportunities to do that. And also, you get to know them in a really intense environment, so it accelerates things. Like, quickly as well. And I'm 33. Like, let's face it. Mm. I'm
OAP.
OAP. No, you didn't even know what that meant the other day.
Yeah, no,
like,
that wasn't
what does
me.
OAP stand
that
for?
That was Hannah. No, it was Liberty. That was Liberty.
Lib goes to me at one point. She goes, what's general knowledge? My brain melted. I was like, I can't explain what that is. It just is.
I just looked over and was just like, I can't, I don't even know how to elaborate on that. Like, you know, you just know what general knowledge is, but you might not actually know the description.
General
knowledge.
What's
it
general
is general knowledge.
Liberty, shout out you.
Shout out Lib, what
I think
girl.
For me, though.
Somebody teach her what general knowledge is, please.
Huh?
Go on, Joe, sorry.
It's right, I was just like this. I think for me, going back in, it's more... You had obviously had like a really good journey your first time. And me, my journey was very like, oh, it was just up and down. I always felt like I was in my own little bubble. I couldn't really be my own self. So I felt like it was nice to go on and just show people, you know, I do have a laugh. I have got banter. I am a nice person.
Yeah.
So I think now that I've shown that, other than showing it on my Instagram or anything like that, I think that was another reason for me to be going on it too. And I was watching the unseen bits and I was like, yes, I burped. That is me.
Your burping, it should be illegal. It's so loud.
Really?
Do it. Go.
I can't do it on cue.
All right.
Well, I could probably could, but I'm not going
to. Okay, this is the part of the show we like to call Pillow Talk, where we ask our guests the important questions in life. And we know if you have a deep chat in the Love Island Villa, you got to be wearing some sunglasses, haven't you, guys?
Yeah. So, yeah. Sometimes absolutely. Multiple pairs.
Yeah. Ooh. Oh, there he is.
Oh, yeah.
Stunning from you.
Oh, we're not putting them on? Oh, you are putting them on. Well, no, you're not. Okay.
It's a fashion choice.
Put one on your eye and one on your forehead.
On my eye?
Yeah.
One on your eye, one on your
one
forehead.
One on my good eye.
So, guys, this one has been picked specifically for you.
Oh. Is this... people writing in, are they? Agony aunting.
Oh, yeah.
Can... This is the one question. Can an ick be reversed?
It's a good
Joanna,
question.
Joanna, I should that, direct this to you.
Yeah,
let
Joanna.
See, everyone was going on about an ick not being reversed. I think it can. Because do you know what? A lot of the time, you do start off relationships and stuff, like, especially me, everyone icks me out. Every single thing, like even like for nose flares when they laugh, icks me out. And then over time, I'm like, no, do you know what? I love that about you.
Yeah.
And ick becomes something you love about that person because it makes them different.
Yeah, I agree. I agree with that.
Do you get
icked? Apparently, I icked you out. So I took my heelys in, but they wouldn't let me have them. And then, because I just thought it'd be really cool to like have a very serious conversation and then heely away. But I did it in the when we were waiting to go in. I had my heelys on and I was rolling around the staging villa we were waiting.
And how was that for you?
And I think somebody said, I think it icked Joanna out.
It sent a shiver up my spine. Do you know what it was? Because they looked like plimsolls from school.
Oh, the shoes are crap.
Yeah.
But they have got wheels on.
Yeah, they've got look like PE, like plimsolls that you get from like, I don't know.
Yeah, lost property bin.
Yeah, exactly. And then he whacked out a wheel on it. And it was just confusing. But because I've been complaining about the Birkenstocks, I hate feet. I've been complaining about the Birkenstocks that you wear all the time.
So what's better, a Birkenstock or a Heely?
I choose Birkenstocks Heely. Over the Heely.
Really?
Promise I would you. Choose a Heely.
I can't roll on a Birkenstock. It'd take me ages to get anywhere.
Yeah.
I would want to try them on one day.
Oh, classic Joe. Hates it at first and then wants it.
Sorry, but can I just say one day? Why is that? Because you're planning to keep hanging out.
Who knows?
It was the
who,
for me.
That's the
knows?
Response.
Hey.
Wait. How'd you do that?
We'll hang out until we get annoyed with each other. I think.
And then you'll put on a pair of heelys and whiz away. Question, Joanna, can an ick be reversed? Has it been reversed?
It has the ick with Chris.
Did you say I gave you the ick? I haven't seen it. Did you say
did I
gave
say
you
I gave the ick?
No, but it's just a general vibe of like, you know.
Did I?
No.
Yeah, the twerking thing. I said, I don't really want to wake up in the morning and walk past my partner and he's twerking and he's sticking his ass out.
Get used to it.
Yeah, I don't think the ick of the twerking could be
that's
reversed.
That's going nowhere.
That can't be reversed. But there's other stuff that can be reversed, yeah.
There's other icks?
Yeah.
Go on.
No, I'm just saying in general, there is other icks that can be reversed.
So do you not think that at some point the twerking, you'll look at it and go, oh, he's glorious.
No.
Okay. I do that a lot.
No. Well, on that note, before we end the podcast, I just want to quickly check in about the fact that in the final, you just told me you met Stormzy.
Yeah, no, I met Stormzy, yeah.
Did you meet Stormzy, Joanna?
No, when did you go meet Stormzy? I think he was lying.
He was sat at the mini fire pit.
Did you really over to him?
I was like, no, I wish. That'd have been real cool. No, I spotted him and I was just like normally production are telling us like what we can do, where we can move and stuff like that. And I was just like, I'm just gonna go say hello to him. Joke was the whole Ryan Gosling thing. Joke, I never said hello to him, and it haunts me to this day.
I remember I didn't want to say it on the phone when you called me afterwards. I was like, "Did you go and say hi and get a picture?" And you were like, "No." And I was like,
"Yeah, I got too scared."
Yeah,
but I was like, "That is never happening to me again. I've learned the lesson." So
what happened?
I just when I did the Barbie thing, I was in front of Ryan Gosling like loads, like multiple occasions, but just never had the bollocks to say
hi.
Hi, I'm Chris. Mm. Which is what it.
Hi, I'm Chris. Hi, I'm Chris, daddy. By the way. Hi, daddy, I'm Chris.
Is that you, daddy? I just...
But then you were on the red carpet having a picky with him, so...
No, I didn't. I didn't do it. That's what I'm saying. That's
was he not in that big red carpet pick of all the stars?
Yeah, but I didn't say hello to him. No. That's the point. So I just went straight over to Stormzy and said, hello, Mr. Stormzy, I love your work. And I said to him, I basically said what I've just said to you. Like, every time I see, like, a real, real famous person, I absolutely cake my pants. And I don't say anything. Told him about the Ryan Gosling thing. We was laughing. And then I said, enjoy your night, sir. And I walked off.
Oh, I'm sure he loved that.
Yeah, I'm sure he'd probably forgot about
Yeah, but I think, you know, you called him Mr. Stormzy, so I think he
Might have been Sir Stormzy, actually.
Sir Stormzy.
I get very proper around...
Well, as you should.
I get nervous.
And Joanna, you didn't get the op. What a shame. You didn't get an opportunity.
I didn't get invited to go over, you see. Every man for himself, you see.
Every man for himself. Well, listen, guys, it's been a deep pleasure to have you both on the show. Joanna, you have passed my tests. So if you would like to continue dating my friend, you may.
Woo! Thank you.
And Chris, what a pleasure to have you back.
Oh, it's been
sad
so
that
nice.
You haven't been on my sofa. No, because I am a lesbian.
Steve.
So let's get her involved.
Yes.
There we go.
Woo! Oh, that's lovely.
What a day to be alive.
What a day to be alive. Ladies and gentlemen, Joanna and Chris. Woo! Thank you very much for listening to Under the Duvet. The podcast, as we know, comes out Wednesdays at 5 p.m. and the YouTube video is live at 12 o'clock on Thursdays. We'll be back next week, so don't miss it because we might have some winners on the show.
Woo!
All right, guys, thank you so much and see you next time.
So thank you. Welcome.